Good morning, students. We are going to discuss about the second part of chapter 2. Here we are going to discuss first what is Blue Jay. So if we look at the Blue Jay is a IDE, SANS Integrated Development Environment, which works as a front-end tool for Java and other object-oriented languages. It contains different tools like editor, debugger and viewer. Actually, what is the meaning of front-end tool or IDE? The meaning of IDE is that it helps the programmer in the front-end and it creates the basic structure of the program automatically, and then it will work as an interpreter without getting into the background commands. Like when we want to compile a Java program in the core Java, we require Javac. But here we don't have to understand how the Javac is working. We just click on compile button and our program is compiled. On the screen you can see the first screen of Blue Jay. Over there you will find project, edit, tools and view. These are the options over there. Now if you want to start your Blue Jay, you just have to click on it. As soon as you click on project, you will get a menu. In the menu you will find all the option: new, open, open recent, etc, etc. Among them you have to click on new project. As soon as you click on the new project, you will the following screen in front of you. In this screen you will find that there is a place called file name where you have to write the name of the file. Actually your project file is being created. When I type here the name, you will find that my project will be created. I will give the name of my file as my first project. As soon as my project is created, you will find that this particular screen will appear in front of you. This screen is called the Blue Jay screen, which is ready with the file name My First Project displayed in the title bar. You can see the window. At the top of the window it is written My First Project. After that, if you want to create a new class, what you have to do, you have to click on the new class. You can click on any one of the part. That one copy like part is there, another is in the menu, new class is there. So you can click any one of them. As soon as you click, you will find the next dialog box in front of you where it will be asking what you want to create. Class, interface and all other options are there. Among them we will start with the class, so that's why we will be clicking on the class, and again we will write the name of the class. This is my first class, so I'll give the name as my first class. As soon as I give my first class name, and then if I just click, then I will see that, click on OK, I will see that this particular screen will appear where you will find your class is created. As soon as the class is created, it will be having a zebra type of symbol written with the class. You can see on the screen. Next, this class is created. Now how it looks also you can see. Next, if you want to open the class, that means you want to get inside the class to see the documents, see the program source code, then you have to click, right click on the class. As soon as you right click on the class, there is an open class option will be there. So as soon as you click on this open class, open, then open source code, that will show you the. In this part you can see that this is the program code, and when you open the code you will find at the top this is document comments, and below that it is given the class structure. Class structure is my class, my first class. Then inside that class it has three properties: one, the data member X, another the constructor my first class and third part is sample method. So when you look at these three properties over here, each property is given some proper instruction at the top in the blue colors. They are written in comments. There are three types of comments over there in Java. One is single line comments, one is multi-line comments, and another one is document comments. So here in this program I have manipulated inside the constructor two things. One, I have initialized the x value. Another, I have written the print statement. So what is this? This is a auto-generated program code by the IDE. It is a auto-generated program code by the IDE. And here you can see where each part is indicate what type of code you should write in which portion. Like over here it has written constructor, so you can write the constructor information, data initialization information. Here initialize the member variable. What exactly is the member variable? Is x. Whatever the value you want to initialize, you can initialize over here. After initializing, I have displayed also. Then third part is the function part, that is int sample method. Over there also it has given you a facility to, you can change that particular code as well as you can leave that particular code as it is. So system.out.println is the command I have used over here as a output statement. Now next part, here you can see that we have created the class, and after creating the class how it looks before the compilation, and second after the compilation how it looks. You can see that Jabra symbol is removed from the class. Then when you have created the class and you want to open your object, means you want to create a new object after writing the compilation and everything, you want to create a new object. Now when you want to create a new object, how you can create? Using the new keyword. You can see the new keyword is given over there, and using that new keyword you can create your new object. The new object is created with the help of the constructor. That's why you will find my first class is the constructor is coming over there, and those constructor code will be executed at the beginning when it is going to create your object. Now when it creates the object, it will show you the this kind of screen where you will find you have to write the name of the object, and here I have written the name of the object as object 1. As soon as I want have given the name of the object, name of the object is also known as name of the instance, and then I press OK, and as soon as I press OK I will get this kind of screen over there. It will show me the terminal window where my system.out.println is worked out, and at the bottom the object is created. You can see as the constructor executed, it initializes object creation by constructor code. In the code we use system.out.println statement that is executed, and output terminal window appeared. You can see output terminal window is appeared. And at the bottom you can see this is an object bench where your object is also situated. Then you want to see the what are the properties are there in my object. In my object I have a property called sample method. Apart from this I have another thing that is called x, but that x is private, that is not showing to outer world. That is why it is not showing over here the other things. As int sample method is a public, that's why it is showing on the screen as a property. Now we can move into the next part. I have created the project and I want to see the project output. Project output means in the project I have created different things that I want to take the printout. That is possible over there in the menu. If you click, you will go to the print option. As soon as you click on the print option, you will find the three options are there. You can print the class diagram, you can print the class source, and you can print the project. Full project readme about the project. You want to have any kind of documentation, that also you can take the printout. Main method we will discuss in process. I am not going to discuss in this class the main method. Thank you for watching my project.